going back to what you were saying about, you know, the ideologies and certain things, I think you nailed something right there, especially when you talk about, you know, having thankfulness, you know, having a mind or having the heart of joy, having the spirit of joy, those different things.
Yes.
That is all about positioning yourself and your mindset to focus on, to focus instead of like accomplishment,
100%.
Which I think is a big thing that we focus on in our generation and society is, you know, what's the material result of said thing? That's
totally agree.
That's what we value. But I think it's actually being in a position to actually have the opportunity to accomplish things. And, you know, that's not a guarantee. Whereas, you know, maybe some people might think that, oh, it's everyone's right to have an equal opportunity, but that's not necessarily the case. And I think we have to show a measure of thankfulness and gratitude that our forefathers who founded this nation, you know, sacrificed and set up for us to even have these opportunities to accomplish things, but also, you know, our parents, for those of us who are younger, you know, and then also for those who are older on the older spectrum, maybe you have kids or grandkids, you know, showing a thankfulness that God has given you a legacy.
Yep. That's a big one.
So I think, I think what we have to do, Matt, is we have to get away from always looking for the material evidence to be thankful for things.
Yep.
And we need to start looking at the intangible, the values. We have to start looking at the things that help, that got us to where we are, or that are getting us to where we are, which is the process itself.
Well, look at the Israelites.
And it may not always be pretty.
Yeah.
But hey, knowing that God is getting you somewhere.
Yeah.
And that there's always a redemptive plan.
That's right there, the redemptive plan. Because think about it. The children of Israel, here God had brought them out of Egypt and through the Red Sea.
Yep.
And literally, they were saying at the Red Sea, oh, well, God, you know, brought us here to die. We're trapped. Yeah. Then God brings them through the Red Sea. And then they turn a 7-day journey into 40 years in the wilderness because of what? Unthankfulness.
Yep.
And literally, they could not be thankful for where God brought them and just stay through the journey.
Just stay on the journey. Well, you nailed something.
Thankfulness.
So because
they forgot everything that was done in the past.
But here's what happened though, because they were bitter and because they got into a place of unthankfulness, they affected the next generation.
That's why even though President Trump got in, have thankfulness in the journey, because guess what? There's still 4 years here that it doesn't mean we stop fighting. Right. We still got to be thankful, because here's the thing. There's a lot of people that are like, yeah, Trump got in, right? But then one attack or thing happens from the left, and it's like everybody just gets in panic mode of like, oh no, here we go. This. And it's like, do you not see God's redemptive plan of what he did? Can we not have thankfulness and be thankful for what God has done? Do we not trust God? That's the other thing. Trust and thankfulness should go together. Like, you should be able to trust God and be thankful and be like, you know what? I see what God has done in the past. I know that my future is set in stone and God's got me.
Yep.
You know, that's why Paul and Silas in jail could have thankfulness and sing praises unto God. Here they had been beaten, put in prison, but it was their thankfulness that also saved a soul that night. The jailer got saved. Think about it. They could have complained. They could have marched off and been like, oh, wow, we're free. But like, what a terrible day. Totally forgot about that guy. Think about that. But their thankfulness for where God got them caused them to keep fighting.
Exactly.
That's why Peter and John even went back out into the town hall or the courtyard or the city and preached after they were in prison.
Yep.
After the angel freed them, they went right back to where
exactly
they preached before and did it again. And I think thankfulness causes you to have an advantage over most people you're around, because it causes you to think not from your thoughts in your head, but it makes your thoughts in your head submit to how you feel in your heart, your spirit. Your spirit led then, because you're thinking then not from a fleshly thing. You're thinking from your spirit. You're living by your spirit. You're thankful for where God has brought you. And when your spirit led, I mean, you can go as far as you want at that point, you know?
Exactly.
Nothing can stop you. The journey is sometimes not going to be easy. But when you're thankful in the journey, that ultimately makes it to where now you're moving with the anointing of the Lord, you know, beside you, the redemptive plan, as you say.
Exactly. You know, thankfulness helps you, like you just mentioned. I was just thinking of those things when you said they went and prayed in the square after that. But what it does is it gives you the big picture, thankfulness. It keeps you focused on the things that matter. So you're not going to get a place of complacency.
No.
You're not going to get a place of fear and stop. You're going to keep pushing.
Because you're having thankfulness, yeah.
Because you're appreciative, one, of what God has done and what he's doing.
Yes.
But it also gives you an appreciation of where he's going to take you.
Yes.
And so that's what I would encourage everybody in America right now. Because
yes.
We should be thankful for what happened with the election.
Yes.
We should be thankful of the things that are changing. But to me, it's also giving us a preview of what lies ahead of the goodness of God. And so when you have the disposition to just focus on, you know, of joy, to not focus on the things that might be challenging or the things that are causing delay, what that really does is it keeps you focused and it keeps you in faith to keep pressing, because on that other side, you know that God is going to provide for you because of what he's already done.
Yeah. And I would say, I mean, you know, look at all the verses that talk about being thankful and having thankfulness. And I mean, notice this. Colossians 4:2, devote yourselves to prayer, being watchful and what? Thankful. Thankful. Okay, you got to be watchful for the future, but thankful. If we're thankful before the moment's even happened, then guess what we're doing? We're praying it through in thankfulness. There's a difference in praying out of being desperate and praying, Father, I thank you that you have this.
Right.
I thank you that this is going to manifest in my life. I thank you that this is coming to pass in America. I thank you that this nation shall be great and is great.